Don Kaufman here, December 7th, 2020, and you are watching the TheoTrade evening video. You know, this marketplace is all fun and games until, of course, the momentum runs dry, and we might be on the cusp of seeing some of that. I'm actually going to display to you a few key underlyings that have really driven a lot of order flow lately that have just been absolutely on fire. That actually had a little bit of reversals throughout the course of today's trading session. A few warning shots being fired across the bow. The other aspect that I want to bring up is, listen, if you're going to take any long positions in this marketplace from this point forward, well, I'm going to display precisely how to do that using some spreads. And last but definitely not least, I exited a considerable number. Again, exited a considerable number of long positions today in the marketplace. And I've actually opened up, if you will, to a more substantial negative delta in the marketplace. Let's get to work on this evening's video here. First and foremost, the S&Ps finished down mildly. The Nasdaq up about 65 handles. But one of the first things I'll point out, if you take a look at the Nasdaq and the powers that be, okay, for the most part, today's rally is brought to you by, once again, 7% move inside of Tesla. Now, a moment ago, I was talking about, you know, it's all fun and games until the momentum runs dry. Clearly, it has not run dry inside of Tesla, at least not yet. When we start looking at today's option statistics, I mean, you know, 1.4 million contracts, you know, is just wild size that's still going through here. And, you know, products even like Apple, the contract size is like 1.2 million, but everything pales in comparison to the size that's going through. So the momentum is still strong, okay, inside of Tesla. And listen, there's just no question that Tesla carried the Nasdaq. All right, so Facebook played into this a little bit today, but even Facebook, spiked up and kind of faded a little bit towards the close. Nevertheless, still up by the tune of about 2%. Again, Netflix incredibly strong, but Netflix, once again, it's a COVID story. But let me show you by what I mean some of the momentum stocks started to reverse today. One of the ones that's just been, people, it's been on fire, and I'd watch this in the days to come, has been none other than Boeing. Boeing, again, you go back a couple of weeks ago, it was a $140 product, now a $240 product. Nevertheless, okay, it's a fairly substantial reversal. Yes, it finished up 2%, okay, but to say it's just off its high, it was off of 244, okay, it's a full-fledged kind of reversal inside of Boeing on an intraday basis. What else reversed? And again, Boeing, it's been in place. A lot of traders on this thing, and it just lost some of its steam. I'll show you other stocks that have lost a little bit of steam. Micron. Now, Micron's one where I actually had a bullish position, maybe petered out a little bit today, seeing a little sell side activity right at the cash open, could not sustain itself. Another one that everybody believed was a big breakout here, okay, Caterpillar. Caterpillar actually reversed by the tune of 2% today. You know, you can go on and on over here. You know, here's another one, kind of a sleeper stock. If you haven't looked at U.S. Steel, okay, here's when I say a little bit of a sleeper stock, this one's been off people's radar, but also started to fade as the day progressed on. Again, I would keep eyes on many of these. The advanced decline line was also, well, 70-30. Listen, there are more declining stocks today. Yes, the S&Ps did finish down, but this is, once again, it's indicative of one or two stocks that are literally carrying the marketplace. You know, you have to ask that question. If Tesla, okay, we're not up 7%, but Tesla, we're down 7%, how bad would the damage be to the Nasdaq? And the answer is without a doubt, okay, it's not just down, you know, what, 0.5%. The damage would be massive because the sell side would then proliferate, okay, to other areas inside of the Nasdaq. So this is something you have to watch very, very carefully in the days to come, because again, it's great, you know, momentum trades can be great, but that's the aspect that I really want to cover tonight, is if you're going to be taking, okay, momentum style trades, you know what, and we'll use one of these, just, you know, wild moves to the upside as an example. In fact, I'll even use Boeing. Okay, because Boeing, it's you know, it's not exactly like the mover and shaker maybe that the Tesla has been. Nevertheless, Boeing still maintains, okay, a fairly substantial volatility. It has had just a phenomenal move to the upside. There's not even the slightest part of me that wants to buy the physical stock here. Now, you know, listen, if you want to get on on board with momentum. And that's exactly the point that I want to make in this evening's video here is, listen, momentum trading is fine. Okay. And if you want to get on that momentum, the point that I want to make is you don't run out and buy yourself a call option. Okay. I mean, listen, you're buying at that point an incredibly high implied volatility, and you're going to be subject then to time decay. You're going to be subject to volatility exposure, a little bit of gamma risk thrown in there. It's a party. Okay. If you want to take that shot that Boeing, for example, is going to crack over 250, okay, then that's exactly the shot that you take. But define your risk in every way, shape, or form. So here's like a $5 wide spread. Again, I don't love to construct out of the money call debit spreads. I don't love the idea, but I am telling you that if you're going to trade, okay, a marketplace for the continuation and for momentum, you just cannot go out there. You can't afford to be wrong for even a day if you own stock. This, you go out, you risk $1.68. Okay, that's it. Sure beats going out there and paying $16, because you pay $16 for an at-the-money option, right? I mean, all of a sudden, to make like 100% on that, think about how phenomenal the move is going to have to be. I'll tell you right now, okay? If Boeing is trading at 240, how phenomenal is the move going to have to be? And we're 39 days out, okay? The stock is going to have to move up roughly $30, okay, for you to double your money on this one. But if you buy this out-of-the-money call spread, for you to double your money, I mean, we clip 255 and you're just gold, you know, gold. You're absolutely going to knock it out of the ballpark. Use spreads at this point in time. Mitigate risk. And the reason I'm reiterating this is, again, I look at some of the some of what's going on in the marketplace. You know, even volatility picked up a little bit today. And what was, again, it was a docile trading session. I don't want to tell you that anything, you know, spellbounding happened in today's trading session, because it's a slop fest. I think the only thing that really stood out to me today is that the bonds reversed course. And if the bonds continue to rally, yeah, that would put a little bit of hurt into the financials. And if you put some hurt into the financials, you're going to knock the S&Ps down. Then we can actually start to see some sell side activity. But that isn't even my concern. My concern is that, okay, I'm seeing people just buy inordinate number of out of the money calls and at the money calls. Okay. And that's just a wing and a prayer kind of trade. Even right now for intraday trade, you can't afford, all right, to be wrong for even a second. And if you are momentum trading, buy those out of the money spreads. Tell yourself, like, hey, listen, it's okay to have, you know, a dollar at risk to be able to make $3 or $4. And that's the kind of trade that you should construct. And for those of you that do not understand how to, you know, build spreads and maintain spreads, well, this is the opportunity right here, right now. All right. Last but not least in this evening, I wanted to discuss, I'm out of a lot of different positions here. One of the ones that I've maintained for a considerable period of time has been IWM. And I want to reiterate this one because, again, I have a couple little option positions left here and there inside of IWM. But net people, I am out of any shares. Again, I'm out of the shares of IWM. I've actually carried shares of IWM since, okay, the early March time frame, and I've now exited all of those for a very, very substantial gain. Okay. All right. What else am I out of? So I'm out of the IWM. I'm actually out of shares of Ford. Okay. I do want to clarify, when I say I'm out of shares of Ford, I am actually selling at the money calls to exit the Ford position. Next one up on the docket. Okay. GE. Very, very similarly, okay, I am selling a boatload of calls to go ahead and exit the GE position, all right? XLE, this is a position that I've been wiggling out of for quite some time. The final shares of XLE will be called away. Last but not least, okay, XOP, which is, again, oil and gas, gas ETF, I'm completely out, all right? The longs that I'm in right now, because I'm not just looking at the marketplace and saying, like, hey, you know, these momentum-type trades are too wild. Listen. Look at something like the XLE. Okay, this isn't just a phenomenal move to the upside. Okay, this is a move that is, again, when you're looking at a product like this, it's trading 30, all of a sudden it's trading 40. Products like this, they don't move, okay, 25, 30%. You know, you start looking at something like Ford, okay, I don't know, a few weeks ago was trading what? $6. It's over $9. Again, you know, you're looking at just spellbinding kind of moves. GE, $6 move to almost 11. You know, you put this into percentage terms, these moves, right? They're just too big, too fast. It's vicious moves to the upside like this that, again, as I said, if you want to be a momentum trader, that's one thing, and use out-of-the-money spreads, okay? But if you're long, at some point, you got to look at this and think, this is not just going to be a pullback. This could get absolutely hideous. Nevertheless, I've exited some long positions, which, again, it actually then opened my position up a little bit. When I say opened it up, I've actually, by exiting my long positions, okay, I'm now incurring more negative delta. I'm incurring now more negative delta. And that means that, yes, I am going to be taking a few more bearish positions. I'm taking more bearish deltas. And that's something, of course, that I'll explain a little bit tomorrow live here in TheoTrade. Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.